tools worked flawlessly. Pump module hung up just a little bit on the external stowage platform before we got it released. He gave it one more little try with the PGT. Bolt didn't turn at all, so he gave it a little yank, and the whole thing came loose. And there you can see it starting to move.
Nice job, guys.
Nice and easy. I'm clear of the course.
Hey, Rex, thanks a lot. Appreciate that.
It's about 1,500 pounds, so it takes quite a bit to move it.
Okay, Ronnie, you ready to lift up the pump module?
Let's do it.
It's 1,400 pounds, buddy.
Let's do this.
Yeah, okay. Ready? Yep.
Here you see Ron controlling the whole thing on the robot arm, and notice he's just very slowly turning the whole thing over. It started out in one orientation, kind of a heads-up orientation, and he needed to turn it 180 degrees around so that when he got down to the payload bay, he'd be heads down in the payload bay and could install the pump module when he got down there.
Now clear of external stowage platform number 2, headed down to Atlantis's payload bay, where the pump module will be secured on a truss support structure at the very back of the bay for the trip back home and an engineering evaluation to determine what caused the pump to fail on the night of July 31st last year. There are 3 spare pump modules residing on various locations on the International Space Station for use in the future should another one go down.
Nice looking spaceship you guys got here.
Why, thank you.
Mike Fossum is preparing the work site at the mission peculiar support structure, as it's called, the cargo truss, basically, at the back of the cargo bay of Atlantis. Just above him is Ron Guerin holding on to the pump module and its support attachment mechanism.
Okay, Ron.
The pump module and its attachment mechanism now aligned to a comparable attachment mechanism on this truss at the rear of Atlantis's cargo bay.
You guys are good with the GCA. We can end GCA and go brakes on.
GCA is complete.
Okay. Brakes are on. You guys are clear for APFR, okay. Egress and ingress.
Mike Fossum has this robotic refueling mission, the RRM, in his hands. He's on the end of the station's arm and moving out of Atlantis's payload bay.
Hey, close encounter to OBSS.
That
cheerful red light on the top.
Here you see the robotics refueling mission just about to be installed and handed off to the Dexter arm over on the lab nadir. I know that everybody at Goddard was holding their breath here, making sure that we were all sending them good wishes, and we were able to get it installed onto the Dexter just fine. Then it was off to install the MISSI, or the Materials ISS experiment, the small portion of that called the ORMATE. Took some photos of that. That's material samples that are exposed to the RAM and wake of space. From there, we went on to work on the grapple fixture that had the little wire sticking out through one of the latch doors. You can see it getting cleared there and then pulled out of the way. That went just like the training. It was just like watching training video to see how well this went, just like we had planned. It doesn't always go that well, but today it sure did, and we were glad to see it. Our final task on the EVA was installing the thermal cover. Here you see it coming out of the bag. You can think of it as a great big comforter coming out of the on-orbit replacement ORU bag. Here you can see it in its final configuration, strapped down. It's got 9 Velcro straps that hold it into position. And about the time that they had it installed in this configuration, the thermal officer in the front room in the Mission Control Center stood up and turned around and said, "I can already see it starting to take effect." He could already see it in his data just that fast. So that's a very successful project.
Well, I'd like to thank there were a lot of teams whose hard work all came into play for this EVA. Linda Brown led a magnificent team of people that put together a lot of stuff, and they had to do it in the hard way with Ron and I, with Ron and me traveling a lot, and not even in country at the same time together a lot. They had to work really hard, and they had a really, really well integrated plan put together with all of the products and the pieces that really came together. And from Goddard, the Colt team, the pump module team, to figure out how to get that thing back. A whole lot of work by a lot of teams around the country, really. Really all came together and today, and that's what made the difference. Hatch is closed.
Oh, I'm a rocket man. Rocket man. I'm burning out of fuse. I'm half alone.
Good morning, Atlantis. This is Elton John. We wish you much success on your mission, and a huge thank you to all the men and women at NASA who worked on the shuttle for the last three decades.
Hey, good morning, Houston. Elton John, music legend. Wow, that is absolutely fantastic. We are absolutely honored that you took the time to join the crew this morning and wake us up.
The spectacle of yesterday's 6-hour, 31-minute spacewalk by Mike Fossum and Ron Guerin has morphed into what essentially is a blue-collar day for the 10 crew members on board as we move into the heart of the mission and what this flight is really all about, and that is namely the transfer of almost a year's worth of supplies from Atlantis's cargo module, the Raffaello multipurpose logistics module that was attached on Monday to the Earth-facing port of the Harmony module of the International Space Station through the use of the station's robotic arm.
Ron Guerin is continuing to work on the waste and hygiene compartment, which is the station's toilet. He is swapping out some air hoses and some other components of that particular device.
Hey, that's the great thing about space flight. You know, one day you're doing the most outrageous thing humans have ever done, you know, spacewalking. The next day you're fixing toilets and packing boxes.
This is Michael Stipe from REM. We wish you much success on your mission and thank all of the women and men at NASA who have worked on shuttle for three decades. From Earth, a very good morning to you.
As you can see, a variety of crew members gathering down in the mid-deck of Atlantis to prepare a variety of cuisine that constitutes the All-American meal that you've been hearing about. This All-American meal, again, was conceived in honor of this final shuttle mission of Atlantis and prepared by the Food Lab folks here at the Johnson Space Center. The crew's All-American menu, beginning with crackers, brie cheese, and sausage. The main course featuring grilled chicken, southwestern corn, and baked beans. And the pièce de résistance will be apple pie for dessert. The station crew will also have barbecued brisket as its entree.
I'm telling you, I've done a lot of these interviews, well, a few of them from space. The technology now is amazing. The picture, guys. You look like you're in a studio, maybe in Omaha, Nebraska or something. The shot is so clear. Is this a hoax? Are you really in space still?
See the hair?
I don't know. We're going to have to do something for you.
Yeah. I want to do it.
I know.
Oh, yeah, I can do that. Watch this. Can everybody float around for us? That was really cool, Chris.
Can everybody float around?
Look at her.
That is so cool.
Look at her.
I think Sandy's hair is pretty much a dead giveaway.
It is.
Well, there you go. There's a pose for you right there.
Good day, sunshine.
Good morning, guys. Wake up. And good luck on this, your last mission. Well done.
Good morning, Houston, and thank you for that message. People all around the world love Paul McCartney's music, and boy, he can rest assured that people all above the earth love his music, too.
Atlantis ISS, please stand by for the White House.
Hello.
Hello, this is the International Space Station.
Well, this is President Obama. Who am I talking to?
Hello, Mr. President. You're talking to the Increment 28 crew and the crew of the Space Shuttle Atlantis.
Well, that's funny, see, because I was just dialing out for pizza, and I didn't expect to end up in space.
Well, yes, sir. It's really an honor and a privilege that you took some time out of your busy day to meet with us.
Well, listen, it is wonderful to talk to you, and I appreciate you guys taking out the time from your mission. I always want to just let everybody know how personally proud I am of you and the amazing feats you guys are accomplishing in space. And I was here in the Oval Office watching you guys take off last Friday. We're all watching as the 10 of you work together as a team to conduct spacewalks and manage experiments and do all the things that are necessary to keep the space station humming. Your example, I think, means so much, not to just to your fellow Americans, but also to your fellow citizens on Earth. And the space program has always embodied our sense of adventure and exploration and courage as you guys work in a really harsh environment. And I know that there have been thousands who've poured their hearts and souls into America's space shuttle program over the last three decades that are following this journey with special interest. And to them and all the men and women of NASA, I want to say thank you. You helped our country lead the space age, and you continue to inspire us. And Captain Ferguson, I realize that you're a veteran of previous flights, but it must be pretty special to be the commander on the last flight of the historic shuttle program.
Oh, absolutely, Mr. President. And just let me say, on behalf of all of the international partners aboard the International Space Station right now, we're all just absolutely honored and privileged to represent our home countries in this multinational effort. And to answer your question, sir, yes, it is an extreme pleasure to be just a part of this fine crew of four who will represent our country on the final space shuttle mission scheduled for an undocking here in just a few days and a landing at Kennedy Space Center in a little less than a week.
Good morning to the Stennis Space Center. Thank you for that lovely greeting. Houston on Air Ground 2 for transfer.
Good evening, Sandy. Go ahead for transfer.
Okay, per all these call downs, I show everything complete in the MPLM, and it's actually chock full. The ISPs have foam on them. All the end cones are full of foam. There's random foam in the RSRs that they came up with, so we're full.
Hats off to you and your crew. You guys have done an outstanding job. Of course, there's a little bit left to do for tomorrow, but that's nothing compared to the job that you guys have already done.
Well, it definitely was challenging, but everybody pitched in. And, of course, I mentioned it before, we had a good plan. You guys did a lot of great groundwork getting us set, and if you guys wouldn't have done such a good job, and the folks at KSC getting stuff packed and keeping track of all the small things, it would have been a nightmare for us, but it really did go smoothly for all that we were working really hard, and we can't even tell you how much we appreciate all the work you guys did on the ground planning this out.
Well, I can honestly say we enjoyed it in some weird way.
Totally understand. Have made some incredible things happen in spaceflight. We thank you for that greeting, and we're looking forward to another great day in space.
Hey, Houston, we've gathered everybody here at the No 2 forward hatch. We have a couple different things we'd like to do today. The first of which is a special presentation, and that presentation is a special flag. That flag was handed to me personally just a few days before launch, and the crew of STS-135, the final shuttle mission, brought it to the International Space Station. And since we've been here, we've prominently displayed the flag on the forward flight deck. We actually had it there a little bit earlier on for a public affairs event, but Doug and I, Rex and Sandy, we just really liked it. It
symbolized what we were all